Fundamentals of software testing, swebbook and testing in a nutshell. So there is this guide to the software engineering body of knowledge, swebbook. Latest version is 3.0. It's a few years old. I think it was 2013 or something when it was released. It's a project of IEEE Computer Society, and it's actually international standard. It consists of 15 chapters, over 300 pages, so there is a lot of material. And the chapter 4 is the part that is related to software testing. And the whole book, it includes a lot of information and definitions, various terms, as it is standard, that's the way it should be. And what is related to testing cases is this chapter 4, which is software testing. So there is several parts in it. First, there is software testing fundamentals. Then there are descriptions of test levels, test techniques, test-related measures, test processes, and software testing tools. And all of these sub-chapters have a lot of sub terms that are described in this document. It can be found from Google. Just Google it and download it. It's a big document, but it's a good way to check what is a correct definition for some term and these kind of things. And then a few words about testing in a nutshell. So now we have had several videos here describing different testing terms, and here is a testing in a nutshell. We have had several videos about how testing is done, and here is a short recap of that. So, test manager, developers and testers create a test plan, and the first test case is based on the technical plans to start the testing. And then developers implement components. Of course, they do coding for the system, and then they carry out the unit testing. After that, there comes the real testers, and they work with developers. They design new test cases based on how the system is built. And testers test components with design test cases and give feedback to developers in integration level. developers note the feedback and fix the most important things. Developers implement more components, and the new components are then connected to the project, and integration tests are carried out. Newly found faults are added as test cases. It continues. When all the components have been implemented and integrated, system testing can begin. Newly found faults are once again added as test cases. And this, when we are adding these test cases, it means that if there is a fault that do not have any test case, then we add a new test case so that we can then run regression tests, and those faults do not do any harm anymore, then they are included in the test cases. When all the major bugs have been fixed, acceptance testing can begin, and once again newly found faults are added as test cases and fixed. And when customer is happy with the software, it is ready and released. It's simple as that. Then of course the final report is written, there is a documentation, source code is provided to customer if it's an open source project. If it's not, then tough luck. And basically the software is ready for maintenance and continuous development phase if there is such. Depends on the software. And if the software is developed further, The steps listed above are carried out, but in smaller scale, so there can be some new, quite big features being developed. So then all these steps are carried out with that project. The original test cases are used in regression testing, which is very important.